What's up, everybody? This is your boy, Double R, Ray Ray Mars, back again with another edition of the Backstage Pass, the official YouTube podcast of your favorite indie wrestler and mine, the man so quick on his feet that he can't be beat, Double R, Ray Ray Mars. And if you can't tell by the tone of my voice, not too happy. And anybody watching this that attended BWO's Showdown event, I'm pretty sure has a good idea of why this may be. For those of you who missed the event, or for those of you who were there and still can't figure out why I'm not too happy right now, I'll give you the rundown. You see, the BWO runs in North Jersey, around East Rutherford, that area, Hasbrook Heights, before they tore down the Pioneer Club. And this is the first time, this past show, that your boy Double R got to wrestle in his home county, Ocean County, New Jersey. A half an hour from where we're sitting right now. Because the BWO doesn't usually run around this area. So, we're going to get new fans. I'm finally going to get a lot of family and friends to come out to watch your boy do what he does best. And we're also going to get a lot, like I said, a lot of new fans. This was my chance, my first chance to really give a good first impression. And in the match I was given, get that opportunity to show BWO management that I belong in the ring with some of their top guys. And that maybe when you're talking about potential contenders to Section 8's newly won United States Championship, I wanted to, my match took place before Section 8 won the title. But just in case he were to win the title, or if Magic were to retain the belt, I wanted to put on a good enough showing in my matchup for BWO management to notice and maybe throw Double R's name into the mix as far as a possible contender for that United States belt. Is a good chance to do that, make a first impression, impress my family, my friends. I was in a triple threat match with Pretty Boy Eric Killer and former BWO US champ Keikoa, the Flying Hawaiian. A lot of people may not know, well, a lot of you probably do, that they used to be BWO tag team champions together. So, I'm in the ring with pretty established superstars, and this is easily the biggest match I've had yet for the BWO. My big chance to really burst onto the scene and make that impression that I've been wanting to make since I arrived. I'm going to upload this match onto YouTube soon as I figure out how to get my camera to work. But, about, I'd say, 10, 11 minutes into the video, you're going to see a fourth individual enter the ring. This individual was not a part of the match, but proceeded to beat the crap out of all three of us. A lot of you BWO fans, people that were at the show, might know him as Joey DeBull, a former BWO heavyweight champion. Now, he's been doing this sort of thing for the last couple of shows ever since he basically came back. We hadn't seen him for a couple of months, and then all of a sudden he started coming back and beating the hell out of people. Whenever he felt like it. So, there's really no surprise that he did that. I'm just kind of upset that he had to pick my match. Just when I finally started to get the upper hand on Keikoa, on Pretty Boy, when it looks like I might finally start to mount enough of an offense to put one of them away, here comes Joey the Bull to ruin all the fun. Now, I live by the motto of don't get mad, get even. And I haven't been in the wrestling business for very long. Just about a year now. But I also know, I feel like I've been in the business long enough to know when to pick my fights and when not to. And as peeved as I am about how my match ended, I'm not going to pursue any additional action against Joey the Bull because it's not my fight. He wants his title back, and I'll let whoever's the champion that he's talking about, whether it be Section 8, new BWO heavyweight champion, Don Montoya, or even the tag team champions, the Saints of Lodi, I'll let them worry about it. But for the record, I apologize to all of the fans that came out, that drove all the way down, for all you fans coming up from Hasbro, they drove all the way down to see your boy get that chance to finally make an impact to my family, to my friends. Apologize that I couldn't have put on a better show and couldn't have won that match for you all. Because Joey the Bull had other ideas. But hopefully I made enough of an impact with BWO management for them to seriously consider throwing your boy's name into the mix as far as a potential maybe U.S. title match is concerned. I'm just saying. But anyway, all that aside, I can assure you that's not going to happen the next time I wrestle in Ocean County, which is going to be January the 30th in Bricktown for NWS at the Elks Lodge. Joey DeBull's not a part of that company. He won't be looking to ruin my fun again. But I highly encourage you all to come out to that show. That's going to be off the charts. Because, like I said, that's going to be Double R's debut with NWS. And, well, debut as Ray Ray Mars anyway. I used to wrestle under another name there, but no one's going to remember that. And like I said, I don't care who my opponent is. I plan on going out there and stealing the show. I've had a lot of people come up to me and tell me that they thought the triple threat match with Keikoa and Hiller was one of the potential show-stealing matches, and that was what I was going for. I plan on doing it all over again on January the 30th. I don't know who I'm wrestling. I'm hearing potential rumors that it might be Nikki Oceans, who's a local guy there, and if that were the case, I think that would be another great opportunity for me to show a guy who's pretty established in the company that I'm wrestling for just what Double R can do. And it could go a long way towards getting me other bookings, more band gigs, stuff like that. Get my name out there. But anyway, I just wanted to give you all a little update on BWO Showdown, how it went for me, how it went in general. Your boy's very sore from the beating Bull gave him. Also, the big news out of Showdown was that an old buddy of mine made his highly, well, maybe not so highly anticipated return to the BWO after a long hiatus. My buddy Rey De Rojo, whose last appearance in the BWO was this past August, where he defeated Darius Carter in Carter's debut match. Little known fact, maybe I think I kind of figured out the reason why Bull came out and attacked me during my match. To my knowledge, the last match Joey DeBull had in the BWO was a loss to Rey De Rojo, who it's known that I'm very, very close with, very good friends with. Some people think I'm his translator, but I really don't speak Spanish. Maybe Bull got a hold of that knowledge and decided to take it out on me, the fact that, you know, we're in my hometown and my friend was his last loss and the last match that he had, and I'm just speculating, but, you know, stranger things have happened. Anyway, your boy is sore. He's going to go lay down, ice up. He's still sore from the beating that he took, and the beating that Rey De Rojo took at the hands of the X-Clan, they beat the hell out of him so bad that it hurt me. All the things that he... I was watching, and I'll upload that match too. My family happened to get that one on tape, because I know that me and him are very tight. Yeah, when they hit him with that curb stomp that you'll see to end the match, that hurt me. That hurt my face, like, literally. You know, it's not because we're the same person. That's not what I'm implying at all. But anyway, I'm going to go ice up, rest, watch WrestleMania 23 on DVD because it's awesome and I can do that sort of thing. I'm going to enjoy my nice lunch of some Wawa chili. Campbell's chili from Wawa, I should say. A Supreme protein bar. 30 grams. Nice 10-inch Italian sub. Number 5, in case anybody wants to know what I get on my sub. And you gotta top it off with an Arizona iced tea. Till next time, this has been your boy, Double R Mars. Thank you for tuning in to the Backstage Pass. If there's anything you want to hear me talk about, any questions you want to ask me, live music performance, hit me up. I'll be happy to oblige. Till next time, it's your boy, Double R, on the Backstage Pass.